this one is extraordinary. And Lady Lazarus, the one about the failed suicides, the despair, the overpowering sense of foreboding, and yet without a trace of anger or hysteria or any appeal for sympathy. The wealth of imagery. Such horrors, but expressed with a coolness, like a murderer's confession. So, have you got a title for your novel yet?
The Bell Jar.
When's it coming out?
New Year.
Will you let me read it?
It's a pot boiler. Could you get me an ashtray?
Sure. I didn't know you smoked.
I don't. But I'm starting. I'm thinking of trying some new things.
Really? Like what?
I'm thinking of taking a lover.
Oh, how glamorous. Who is he? Look, I know how you feel.
No, you don't.
I do. We share in common that I tried to.
How?
Same as you, sleeping pills. I took too many. Everybody does, don't they?
Sometimes I feel like I'm not solid. I'm hollow. There's nothing behind my eyes. I'm a negative of a person. It's as if I never thought anything. I never wrote anything. I never felt anything. All I want is blackness. Blackness and silence.
Look, one thing I do know about death is it is not a reunion or a homecoming. There's no, your life doesn't flash before you and the missing piece of you clicks into place. It's just, there's just fuck all. There's nothing.
So what do you do when your life gets as bad as it can and just keeps getting worse?
You just keep going. Look. Listen. You are so beautiful. And you've a wonderful mind. And you are a great poet. And you and Ted, you understand each other in ways that other people can only dream about. So for God's sakes, don't throw it all away just because...
I don't want to hear her name.
I was going to say, just because of an affair.